Yeah, wait.
Set story?
Yeah, I was trying to prepare. Like, okay.
Yeah.
10 holes. Once in a little UEF base, not that far from here, there was a problem.
Let's start. Yeah, okay. Let me start with this distance. Okay.
10 holes. Once in a little UEF base, not far from here, there was a little problem. Tech 1 engineers had started dying off, one by one. In the morning, their commanders would see them lying outside, with 10 holes in their chest. The T1 units thought it was the work of the neighboring Cybern base. But then one night, a commander by the name of Fred, 69, was closing his air factory for the night. It was very late, and he was anxious to get home, so he landed all his air units. He shut off all the lights and closed the land factory, which was producing engineers, with a satisfying click. As he turned around to upgrade to T2, he saw a dark shape in the distance. He stood still, trying to make out what it was. As it got closer, the commander turned to go. It was the last move he ever made. The next day, they found him with 10 holes in his chest, and there was no share. This made the other bases quite worried. They were scared of more engineers and commanders getting killed. So one night, two brave innocents, Morgan and Entropy, went out to get rid of the problem. They each took some nukes and some artillery, and they said goodbye to their father and kissed their grandmother on the way out. I'm just gonna leave that part in. The two commanders decided to split up. One would go by the site of the murder, and the other would wander in the sea. If one was attacked, they could use Skype to contact the other. So they set off, keeping a close eye on the flying units. Nothing seemed to be happening. It was a calm game.
And it looked like Jesus Eco.
It was a calm game, and it seemed like they would get back to their bases safely. But then suddenly, Morgan heard a crackling in the bushes behind him. He tried to Skype Entropy, but it was too late. Something leaped out of the bushes and tackled him, gorging his metal chest with its nails, deplugging him from all his upgrades. Luckily, Entropy heard the commotion and rushed to help him. He leaped through the air and did a somersault. an overcharge and cut off the creature's right hand with his laser sword, because we need that in FAF. The creature screamed and ran. Entropy took Morgan to the hospital, to the repairing stations, and they repaired him. The engineers called them heroes, and finally they got back to the bases in 6 in the morning. Only their grandmother was up. what's the professor called?
Brackmon.
Only Brackmon was up, so they said good morning. They went back to bed. Neither of them noticed she was missing her hand. Oh, it was Brackmon! It was Brackmon!
My dear child.
How did she lose her hand?
Well, he leaped through the air and cut off the creature's right hand.
Oh.
Yeah, so...